Ah, mekat, mekat.
Selamat Hari Raya.
Oi, selamat Hari Raya. Kami dah sampai masjid dah bersama dengan tukang-tukang sembelih.
La ilaha
Allah.
كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلا لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون لا صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعد جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله والله أكبر الله أكبر ولله
الله أكبر 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 Connected. We cannot play only and just we have to say the khutbah, inshallah, we'll try to make it short as much as we can, so we can go, inshallah. So we'll start now. So, istaqimu alhamdulillah.
Jamak-jamak.
Allahu Ekber. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر موضوعة وأكواب موضوعة ونمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن وله الثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم الله أكبر 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 لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد الله أكبر كبيرا والحمد لله كثيرا الحمد لله على نعمه وآلائه التي لا تعد ولا تحصى. Dear brother in Islam, Ramadan finished too fast. Just few days ago we are starting Ramadan by saying welcome Ramadan, ayyam al ma'dudat, the month of Ramadan is the best month. Now, very quickly we are saying goodbye Ramadan. But alhamdulillah we are saying goodbye, we have some hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted our prayer and our fasting and our zakat and our all acts of worship during this month. And I'd like to share with you some good news from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to all those who fast the month of Ramadan in the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes. فعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم للصائم فرحتان يفرحهما إذا أفطر فرح بفطره حين يفطر وفرحه حين يلقى الله سبحانه وتعالى. The Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said there are two joys for the fasting person, the joy when he breaks his fast and the joy when he meets his Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the good news from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After this month, may some of us feel this was difficult month to fast during work, during studying, during this weather. But this good news lets you feel that you are happy. The first thing, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِذَا أَفْطَرَ فَرِحَ الْفِطْرِ, when he breaks his fast. And this word actually referring to two things. One, every day in the month of Ramadan, when we break our fast during the Maghrib time, we feel happy. And today, the day of Eid al-Fitr, the day after the month of Ramadan, when we start to break our fast, Subhanallah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that he will joy, he will be happy in that day. So today is the day of happiness, the day of joy, the day of pleasure. And I'd like to share with you very quickly how to make it happy this day. First of all, we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who guided us, the one who gave us the ability to achieve this month and to fast it as he likes subhanahu wa ta'ala. And follow these thanks by saying astaghfirullah al-azim. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his forgiveness, because after any ibadah, ibadah al-hajj, ibadah al-salah, ibadah al-zakat, we have to say astaghfirullah al-azim. Astaghfirullah for the things that you was guilty in. So first of all, we have to say alhamdulillah and astaghfirullah and continue worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because the real day of Eid, the day when you on the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the day when you do some good action to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Secondly, we have to relate each other. As a brother in Islam, this is a very important thing and very important topic we have to speak about. One of the things let us sad most of the time, our relationship with others, with our brothers, with our family. But subhanAllah, Allah always guides us, and Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also guides us to forgive and forget, to pardon our brother, to tolerate him. Just forgive for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So if we have anything in our heart to our brother in Islam, just for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is normal. Normal.
Because I am new here, I don't know the difference between dangerous alert and normal.
So, to be happy, we have to tolerate each other. To empty your heart from any sadness towards your brother in Islam. Just as I mentioned, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. And you will feel this happiness in your heart. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in one hadith he said, أَحَبُّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ سُرُورٌ يُدُخِلُهُ الْقَلْبَ الْمُسْلِمُ عَلَى قَلْبِ أَخِيهِ الْمُسْلِمُ. The best act of worship that pleased Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do you know what? When you let your brother in Islam happy, سُرُورٌ تُدْخِلُهُ عَلَى قَلْبِ, when you make him, when you please him, when you let him feel happy by anything, by words, by gift, by helping him, by pardoning him, to forgive him. This is the best thing that you can do in this day to share the happiness among each other. Another thing, especially during our rahim, kinship, your brother, your father, your mother, we have to be in touch with them. We have to contact them. We have to start our day. I all the time say that because actually, if you did not start your Eid day by contacting your brothers and close family, I think you have a problem with them. Or you have something wrong, something missing. Start with them before anyone, before yourself. Start with your close kinship, especially if your parents are alive. If they are not, just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them. Ameen. So dear brother Islam, as I mentioned, this is the day of joy, the day of happiness, the day of pleasure. So let's make it like that. Do not feel sad. Do not do anything to let others feel sad. Forgive. And let them happy and joy enter to your kids also by giving them gift, by giving them money this day, by taking them outside to any park. We have to do something in the way that to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the same time to make ourselves happy, to follow the sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي. الله أكبر 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 لا إله إلا الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر ولله الحمد. So dear brother Islam, this was the first joy, the first good news from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the second point, that when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will see the rewards of your fasting. This one hadith, an Sahl radiallahu anhu, he mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, there is a gate in paradise called Ar-Rayyan. And those who observe fasts will enter through this gate on the day of resurrection. May Allah make us from them. Amen.
Amen.
And none except them will enter through this gate. It will be said, where are those who used to observe fast? They will get up and answer, and none except them will enter through it. After their entry, the gate will be closed, and nobody will enter through it. This, when you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will see the reward of your fasting. So dear brother Islam, again we have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to say astaghfirullah al-azim. And the last thing I'd like to share with you today, that we, in this day, special day, we have to remember that we have our brother in Islam. They are defending the honor of the Ummah around Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. Do not forget them. keep them in your dua. We are celebrating between and with our families, our close friends. We're very happy, but they are defending Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa and defending the honor of the Ummah. At least keep them in your mind and keep them in your dua. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to free Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa from Al-Yahud. Ameen. اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات الاحياء منهم والاموات انك يا ربنا سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات تقبل منا رمضان يا رب العالمين وارزقنا الفرح والسرور في الدنيا والاخره يا ارحم الراحمين اللهم كن لاخواننا المجاهدين المقاتلين حول المسجد الاقصى يا رب العالمين اللهم ايدهم بمدد من عندك وايدهم بقدرتك وحولك يا رب العالمين ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته تقبل الله منا ومنكم
Satu je. Perfect.
Bye bye.
Selamat Hari Raya. Duk raya, duk raya.
Raya
semua nak
bagi.
Memang kena bagi lah, mana? Tak prepare pun. Terima kasih.